All right, how's everybody doing? Hopefully everybody is well. It's officially 7 a.m. Our workout for today, the Great Depression. We have a 20-minute AMRAP for you guys today. So definitely going to feel a little bit on the longer side, but this was kind of a fun one, right? Just kind of keeps you moving the whole time, or hopefully it does. We're going to start off with 30 step-ups. These are going to be unweighted step-ups. If you've got a box, guys' RX would be 24 inches, ladies' RX would be 20 inches, so the height itself should kind of make it challenging enough. So definitely don't need to add any weight to the equation unless you're stepping up to like a plate or something like really, really small. 30 step-ups. If you can't do step-ups, you can sub for a forward stepping lunge. You can go with toe taps, right? So the same thing, just 30 on each side. Or you can go with some hurdle step-overs. And if you need to see what any of those look like, we'll show you what they look like in a little bit. The second movement is going to be 15 strict dips. So if you have rings or you have a dip station, you can obviously use that. And we're looking for as good of a range of motion as you're able to get. So at the top, fully extended elbow at the bottom. If you can, try to get your shoulder a little bit lower than the height of the elbow. And I'll show you again what that looks like in a minute as well. If you can't do strict dips, or maybe you just don't have a spot that you can do them, you can do them also on like a bench or a box or whatever. If you have you have a box that you're doing step-ups on, you can go for push-ups or you can go for shoulder taps. And if you're going to be doing shoulder taps, you're going to be doing 45. And so it's an uneven number. I apologize for that, but if you want to do an extra one, right, you can always do an extra one. And then final movement we're going to have is a 75-foot single arm overhead carry on each arm. So it'll be a total of 150 feet. You're going to go up and overhead with one arm, take a nice long walk, right? So 75 feet down, and then swap arms, come back 75 feet. If you can't go overhead, we can sub for a front rack or a suitcase carry instead, right? So if you can get the dumbbell to here, go for the dumbbell here. If you can't, you can just hold it down at the side. You can even just go for a walk, right? So if you're not able to hold weight, just go for a walk, go for a lateral shuffle, right? Something along those lines that just kind of keeps you moving for the entirety of the 20 minutes, right? If you do have rings, and you're planning on using them today and you know for sure you're going to need bands, this would be probably a good one to grab some bands on, because obviously there isn't going to be any kipping on the dips. So those should be pretty challenging as you start going through. So let me show you the three movements that we're going to be doing. First movement, again, the step up. Try to make it as much of a single leg drive as you possibly can so we don't wind up pushing off that opposite foot. And then try to make sure you're standing as tall as you can at the top, right? Main mover is going to be the glutes on this one, right, your butt. The strict dips, if you don't have a set of rings, which I'm not going to use, I'm just going to use the box. You're going to go hands just about shoulder width, maybe a little wider than shoulder width. And again, think about controlled lowering and whatever that object is that you're moving down, try to think about your entire body kind of moving up and down that object versus shifting away from it. So I'll show you what I mean. Let's see the box. So that versus but you want to stay a little bit closer to that object, again, so that you can keep a better range of motion and we've got more of a straight line as far as our shoulders are concerned, right? Going straight up, straight down. And then finally, our single arm overhead carry. You could use a dumbbell snatch or you could use a push press. Once we get the weight up, again, you're just going to go for a walk. And then once we're in that locked out position, you'll walk down 75 feet, swap arms, and then do the same thing on the opposite side.
Hey, Jake, how much weight for that?
How much do you have?
I have choices.
Let me hear your choices.
I have dumbbells up to 45 pounds.
Try like a 25 to a 30 pound dumbbell. I think that should be good.
Okay. Thanks.
Got it. Any other questions on any of the movements or?
Jake, if we're not going to go overhead and just do like a carry or a hold, mm-hmm. how long should we do that?
It'll be the same thing. So it'll still be the 150 feet. You just
I can't walk anywhere either.
Around 75 feet back. Okay. Well, you could just do a march. Yeah. So just do a march. So in other words, you'll if you're going to go front rack, bring the dumbbell up to the front rack and then.
Okay.
Should take somewhere in the vicinity of like maybe 30 to 40 seconds to do the walk. So if you're going to do a march, maybe go 15 seconds on each side, 15, 20 seconds on each side, depending on how heavy the weight is.
Apologies, I have one more question.
Yeah, go ahead.
If the step-ups, if I can't do them, the front lunges, is it still just 30 total or?
Yep, and okay. it'll also be unweighted, so you don't have to add any weight to the equation.
Okay, thanks.
Got it. All right, any other questions?
The step-ups are unweighted, you said?
Correct, yep. All right. So we're actually going to start off with a sub for one of our movements, right? So our warm-up is going to begin. We're going to have 4 sets, 10 forward stepping lunges. So if you were curious, now's your chance to try it out, right? Take a nice big step forward. Try to make sure the shin stays vertical. Drive off that front foot, stand tall, and then swap. It's going to be 10 total. After you've done those 10 forward stepping lunges, we're going to go 8 push-up to shoulder tap. So you're going to perform a good push-up, and then just one by one, right? Hand's going to come up off the floor while that opposite hand stabilizes. Should feel a little similar to yesterday. You're like, why is my chest sore? And my abs. 8 push-up with shoulder taps. Oh, Nicole, those legs a little sore? Ruh-roh. Murph, gotta love it. All right, final thing you're gonna do if you've got, especially if you've got some lighter weight, grab something a little bit lighter. We're going to pop it up and overhead. And you're going to hold it for 15 seconds in a single arm overhead static hold. So basically that just means take your weight, get it upright, and we'll hold that overhead position for 15 seconds on one side, 15 seconds on the other side. So if you're ready, we're going to go all together in 3, 2, 1, go. If you already started, you already got your own timer, you can just keep on moving. Three, two, one, and rotate. So you do the same thing on the opposite side, right? 15 seconds on that arm. Ready? And go. And rest. Good. So we've got 3 more sets of that, right? A total of 4 sets. So you're going to go 10 forward stepping lunges, 8 push-up with shoulder tap, and then 15 seconds in a single arm overhead static hold on each arm. I would suggest just getting your own timer going if you're able to, just so you can keep track of that 15 seconds, right? But you could also count in your head. It's only 15. Ten forward lunges, 8 push-up with shoulder tap, 15-second single arm overhead hold. And as you guys are going through the warm-up, I will talk quickly about our workout again. We got a 20-minute AMRAP, 30 step-ups, 15 strict dips, and then a 75-foot single-arm overhead carry on each arm. Good. Subs for today, again, if you can't do the step-up, you can go for a forward-stepping lunge. You can go for a toe tap or a hurdle step. For the dips, you could go with push-ups. You could go with shoulder taps. Or talk to me and we'll find a good sub for you if you can't do either of those. And then for the overhead carry rate, if we don't have a sub for that, or we can go with a front rack, or we can go with a suitcase carry. You guys are still moving through. Once you guys finish that fourth and final round, let's take a minute and rest. Bathroom, water, whatever you got to do, and then we'll get started all together. And as you guys start progressing through rounds, if you want to start moving on the 15-second overhead static hold, you can. And you want to just kind of get used to walking around a little bit, you can do that. This guy's everybody looks like they're pretty close to being done. Again, if you're all finished, I'll give you guys a minute. Just kind of get yourself situated. And we got 30 step-ups. Those are going to be unweighted alternating legs. Guys, 24 inches. Ladies, 20 inches. But obviously, work with what you got. 15 strict dips. And then 75 feet each arm of a single-arm overhead carry. If anybody has questions, anything like that, anybody needs extra mods, Talk to me.
Jake, it's 30 total step ups?
30 total, yep.
Okay.
Yeah, alternating legs.
What would RX be for guys for the overhead carry?
Like weight wise, maybe probably like a 50. I would have probably left this one more open ended if this was like an in the gym workout, just because everybody's a little bit different. So if you have like normal like open weight, that'd be good. Anything heavier than that? I mean, again, it kind of depends on your overhead position. Right? If you got good overhead position, then you could always go heavier. If you struggle a little bit more with it, I'd go lighter and try to focus on letting the shoulders sit back and down and just keeping your elbow extended. And yeah, technique always, right? Technique always first. Yeah, especially if those shoulders are super tight from the other day, right? Go with something that's a little bit more moderate and just focus on that external rotation of the shoulders, pushing up on the weight and, you know, holding it in a good position.
Jake, I didn't measure my driveway, but like 75 feet is like 30 steps roughly, would you say?
Yeah, give or take. I mean, I would even just kind of time it on your first one if you have like a clock with you. Just go like 20 seconds out, 20 seconds back.
Okay.
That's give or take, that's going to be about how much time it'll take.
Okay, thank you.
You got it. If you guys are ready to go, just kind of stand there in front of your screen, look super bored, or give me a thumbs up, and that way I'll know everybody's ready. Cool. Everybody looks pretty close to being ready. Give you guys another like 30 seconds if you're still getting situated. All right, we got 20-minute AMRAP. We're going to be starting with 30 step-ups, right? 30 box step-ups. We'll be able to see the clock soon once we get it started. Hope everybody's good. I think I see everybody. Cool. Here we go, guys. 10 seconds. Go. Sorry about that. Nice job, guys. Nice big step. Just stand all the way up at the top of every one of those reps. All right, that's it, guys. Good job, Vicky. Good, Sarah. Try to make sure you stand up all the way, Sarah. Nice and tall at the top. There you go. Nice, Aunt. Good job, Nicole. Good job, Dietrich. Nice, Maria. Good job, Stacy. We got 30 step ups. Since you've done 30, we're moving on to 15 dips. Nice, Chris. Good job, Katie. Good, as you're going through those dips, try to stay as close to that object as you can that you're dipping on. Stay real close to it. After you've done those 15 dips, you've got a 75-foot single arm overhead carry each arm. Nice, guys. Job Matina. Job Frank. Nice. Good job, Nicole. Good, Sam. That's it, guys. Keep pushing up on that weight. Keep the abs tight. Good, Maria. Job, Chris. So, Chris, you don't need to add weight to the lunge. If you're doing lunges, you can just go bodyweight lunges. That should be challenging enough. Sorry, Chris Oleth. I was talking to Chris Garcia. Job, Daddy. Nice job, Vic. Gonna find that nice steady pace on your step ups. Just keep moving. Remember that single leg drive. Don't forget to alternate legs. Job, Toby. Good, Maria. There you go. Nice, Stacy. Good, Sarah. Try to get a little deeper, Sarah. And then, Tara, you're probably going a little bit too deep on the dips. You could probably stay up a little bit higher at the bottom. There you go. Nice, Katie. There, Chris. Job, Dietrich. Job, Nicole. Job, Toby. Try to make sure you extend those elbows, Toby, at the top. There you go. Good, Michael. Nice. There you go, Stacy. Job, Maria. Good. Chris Oleth, try to step a little higher. So bring that knee up a little more. There you go. Yeah, girl. Nice, Nicole. That's it, guys. Keep moving it. Job, Frank. Good, Sarah. Nice, great work, guys. Keep those transitions nice and fluid. Keep moving. Got plenty of time left. Sick, guys. What's up, Sam? Thanks, Chris. That's it, guys. Don't stop moving. Stay consistent. Good job, Maria. Good job, Frank. Good job, Stacey. Good, keep breathing. Try to get a little deeper, Nicole. Nice, guys. Good, Sam. Keep those abs tight. Keep pushing up on that weight. Hi, Stacy. Good, Daddy. Good job, Vicky. There you go, Maria. Come on, Maria, right to it. Yeah, girl, you got it. That's it. Nice. Good job, Dietrich. Nice, Bettina. Stay steady, guys. We just hit the halfway point. Nice, Aunt. There you go, Aunt. Good, Nicole. Good job, Chris. Guys, keep those transitions nice and fluid. One exercise right to the next. Good job, Tara. Nice, Bettina. Good job, guys. Try to keep that good range of motion on your dips. Single leg drive on every step up. Keep breathing. Hi, Sarah. Nice, Chris O. Here you go, Frank. Okay, come on, Toby, right to it. There you go. Try to extend those elbows all the way, Toby. Good, nice guys. Good job, Michael. Nice, Sam. Good job, Sarah. Still got plenty of time left. Keep moving. There you go, Aunt. Good job, Dottie. Nice, Maria. Nice, Nicole. Good job, Stacy. Nice transition. Nice, Chris. Good job, Dietrich. Good job, Toby. There you go. Nice transition, Toby. Nice, Sam. We got a little less than 5 minutes left. You guys doing great. Good, Matina. There you go, Sarah. Nice, Tara. Nice, Michael. That's it, guys. Good job, Nicole. Vicky. Gotta keep pinching those shoulders back on your dips. Keep those abs tight on your overhead carries. Stay nice and steady on those step ups. There you go, Toby. Good job, Stacy. Good job, Chris. Yeah. Good, Sarah. Nice work. Nice, Frank. That's it, guys. Keep that good range of motion, even when you start getting tired. So you stand up all the way, every one of those step-ups. Gotta lock those elbows out on your dips. Just about 2 minutes left. That's it, Matina, you got it. Good job, Vicky. Job, Sarah. Good job, Ant. Keep it up, guys. We got less than 2 minutes left. Don't stop moving now. Made it this far. 90 seconds. Good job, guys. Stay steady. You're almost there. One minute. So final minute, guys. Keep pushing. Nice, guys. 30 seconds. That's it, guys. Almost there. Find that last gear. Keep moving. 10 seconds. Three. Two, one, time. Yeah, nice job, guys. Great work, everybody. How was that? It's kind of a rhetorical question. I totally know how that was. Especially after doing Laredo. Or Murph, right? Either one. I'm sure those legs are probably feeling a little stiff. It's all right. There's nothing better to get out that lactic acid and move around a little bit. Great job, everybody. Our accessory work for today, just in case you're still feeling fresh, we've got 5 sets, 10 glute bridges. This is going to help you just kind of decompress your lower back, and also at the same time, it's going to help you activate your glutes, right? If you want to add weight to the equation, you can obviously feel free to do that. So 10 glute bridges, and then 10 two-breath side planks. So the only thing that makes it a two-breath side plank is you're going to hold that side plank for exactly 2 breaths, right? So everybody's a little bit different. Think it should be about 4 seconds on each side, give or take, right? 2 really slow, controlled breaths, and then you're going to rotate to the opposite side. Again, hold there for 2 slow breaths, and so on. So I'll show you what that looks like real quick if you haven't seen this before. And so on. All right, so we're going to be going for 5 sets of that, 10 glute bridges, 10 two-breath side planks. Nice work today, everybody.
Thanks, Jake.
Thanks, Jake.
Thank you, Jake. Goodbye.
Great job, guys. Have a great day.
Thank you, Jake.
Thanks, Jake.
Got it.